My mom's gonna be so jealous.
Good morning, people. It is 7:30 in the morning. Jordan and I are headed to what is his first ever client consult or potential, I don't know, client job, which is super exciting considering the one reason Jordan has stayed with me for a year is because he wants to be doing more client work. So it'll be fun to like bring him to what's essentially gonna be an on-site visit at two different potential clients and show him the ropes, show him kind of how I go about doing stuff. And then just fact find with the clients. So little morning jounce a little earlier than we are normally together. Should be fun.
It's like going to work with dad.
Jordan's got it combed his hair. He put on like real pants. He looks like his first day of school. First spot is a hair salon that's being built on. Weirdly enough, my mom's owned a hair salon my whole life. So hair salons are like ingrained in my DNA and quite nostalgic for me. So a little different than a normal client. She wanted me to see the space. She's got a vision for it, which is awesome. We'll be able to kind of chat back and forth on what she's looking to do. And hopefully it's a pretty cool spot. My first time here though, which is typically interesting to say the least. Oop, and I missed it.
All right, so yeah, you were showing me a little bit on the drawing here.
I'm thinking instead of having stations on an angle, I want them to be so that every person can turn their head and look out.
The window?
Yeah.
Got
Does that make sense?
So, yeah, so you want everything facing.
So essentially it kind of goes this way a little bit.
Gotcha. Very cool. You'll have essentially two stations here.
Correct.
Larger.
Yes.
And then if this is to scale, which it is, I would suggest something that's like 8 foot long.
Okay.
For that many, just to make sure it's nice and roomy.
How many inches is that?
96. So we can walk through that a little
bit. That actually sounds perfect to me.
Do you really like the that live edge look?
I do.
That's kind of like what we specialize in, so yeah. I was super pumped. One thing that I like to try and emphasize, and especially because you're in an older building,
yeah,
and it was an old automotive building, so it's got a little bit of an industrial vibe, you know, yes, and that kind of stuff, and then the look you were sending had a lot of metal, a lot of wood. It's obviously like what we do, and I think being able to just keep things nice and basic and then show off both of those kind of material types, it'd be a super cool look. And when you send over like the live edge four person station, yes, through the double mirrors and stuff, it's a cool vibe. The reception desk, my only piece of advice in just doing this kind of stuff would be, it's gonna depend on how much stuff you're gonna have behind the desk. If you've got a lot, I don't know, if you're running like multiple computer printers, we got wiring and stuff.
Yeah, I would foresee all of that going under,
yeah,
the front of the desk, and then this would also have electricity on it for a sign.
Okay.
You know.
Just super cool.
Yeah, this has been a dream of mine for a long time.
I know in like the hair and in the beauty world, the dream is always in your own spot, so it's pretty cool. Tonality wise, what's your flooring?
I haven't chosen.
You haven't decided?
No. It's gonna be a probably a wood
lamp. Yeah. It's much more difficult to match wood tones and try to get everything to be essentially like a monochromatic.
Yeah, and it doesn't
paint. Yeah, and I always lean to like beams would look phenomenal, you know, dark wood would look good in this situation or this area.
Yeah.
And then I really like the cleanliness and the white. Those are some super cool wash stations. My mom's gonna be so jealous.
I have to bring her to the opening party.
Yeah.
She's gonna be proud though. You know all these terms, I was just like, oh.
Wow.
You know more about hair salons than I would have ever guessed.
For my whole life, like, I've been in a hair salon.
So yeah, it's like, that's so
I can't go anywhere else to get a haircut. So that's the only one I've ever been to. Like I said, it's nostalgic and it's cool. And this sounds super fun. Well, we'll get out of your hair.
I'll get out of my hair.
It was so nice meeting you.
Nice to meet you. Yeah.
I'm really looking forward to this.
Super cool project. We're really stoked. I think that what she's looking for is going to fit really well into what we do. Did you learn a thing or two in there, Jordan?
I did.
So we're on to appointment number two for the morning, which is it's kind of a downtown conference table this client's looking for. Should be a pretty artistic and cool project. I think they do fiber optic stuff, so they want to get weird with it. So this one should be fun too. So we're in the North Shore now, and we've got a pretty cool client that we're looking to do a conference table for, so let's go check it out.
You probably get up to like 12, 14 squeeze.
Yeah.
At a 14 foot table.
And sometimes we'll have like big meetings where people are like standing in the corner with a seat in the corner or something like that.
I noticed you guys have some power and stuff run. You got ports in the floor. It looks like a center port.
Yeah, so this thing, no outlet necessarily.
Okay. So we'll need to, you know, like one central hub for wiring and then these two.
Well, yeah, like there's, if you look under the table here, there's like a lot of stuff underneath it. If we can have like a central, like the one table I saw you did, it was like the Pittsburgh Skyline one.
Yeah.
You had like a center thing in there that was like a shelf almost.
Yep.
If we can have just like a shelf or something like that where we can do that and then have the wiring to set devices on the table, that'd be great.
Perfect. And do you think you need more like plugs or outlets? Or
I was just going to say, I see like plugs all the way.
But yeah, like you can see like right here,
sparked out.
Like, we can do two like super sleek, they're like stainless, they'll like, you know, like a fold down and pop.
Yeah, I would assume like a rectangular cut through here and then like just basically a circle for that mount for this thing.
Yeah.
We were talking about the center with the squid, you know, logo. But yeah, we weren't sure if there's anything else that, you know, we might want to showcase that ties into the company.
Zeros and ones, like matrix.
Anyways, we can give this some thought.
Yeah.
And
then we also talked about like around that squid in the center, like putting like the challenge coins in the acrylic, like the almost like the bullet casings.
We could do a ring around the outside, and we could do an acrylic inset into it, so that way it's a little more durable than glass as far as being taken in and out and having to be careful with that kind of stuff. And then we could have it pop out if you guys get some rings and stuff that you could easily just, you know, there'll be finger holes, something just kind of thing, add them in there, organize them in whatever direction, and we would be able to surround the squid. So just looking at this logo itself, the squid, is that an octopus or a squid?
Octopus.
The octopus kind of reaches out into the ring. What we do is we'd have that outside of, we'd have the blue ring in the logo, and then outside that ring, we could put the challenge ring. Yeah. And we'll do like a felted bottom and stuff so they can sit there. You guys like that idea?
Yeah, I like that idea a lot.
Yeah.
Color-wise though, you want to stick with these, this palette?
I think so.
And stuff?
Yeah.
And you guys like the epoxy resin stuff that you've seen us do?
Oh, it looks amazing.
It looks amazing. Cool.
So what we'll end up doing is we're not going to be able to hit for the resin like the perfect color match. But we'll get super close. We'll get some samples of stuff that are gonna fit like really close. It's super cool and unique. It's a little more involved than a Black Rifle logo.
Yeah.
But it gives you an opportunity to be a little bit more artistic. Do you have any species of wood or anything that you guys like or particular to, or are you down with any, my sort of like?
Yeah, when everything looks good.
Yeah, I would say you're the artist.
Cool.
So that was awesome. I think this could easily become one of the coolest projects we've ever done.
The coolest!
That was really cool. And we got recognized by a guy from France.
Yes, two people follow us on their team, which was awesome. Which means that somehow people are finding us, which is phenomenal. So I'm really excited to get to these designs. This should be a fun one. Jordan, have you learned anything today?
Yeah. I learned I want to work at that office.
They had top of the line coffee maker. They were making French toast when we got in there.
Yeah, that was really cool.
We got to go and riff on some design. All right, Jordan. So I would say pretty successful morning for the most part. Mm-hmm. Susie, I want to get working on the two stations first.
Yeah.
My vision is something super basic for the legs. I want to go with a 2 or 3 inch tube. Okay. An H-style leg, something that's gonna be substantial enough, but we're gonna have to run power through it. And then on top of that, cross member to keep this thing from racking, because four people are gonna be working on it.
Right.
Right, so we're gonna go with the 2-inch tube. We want this to be roughly, I think if they want it counter height, it's gonna have to be like 35 inches tall-ish. We can tweak with that. Table's 8 feet, so we'll go with, you know, it's gonna be something like this.
Gotcha.
8 foot total. So for the base, we should tie this all together so we can hide any electrical if we need to. For the reception desk, I want to do a waterfall desk.
Mm-hmm.
Waterfall.
That's 40 inches. We're going to have to come back and see if this thing needs to be ADA compliant.
What is ADA compliant?
It's for wheelchair accessibility.
Man.
Okay, so then we'll do the branding here, and then what we'll do is build kind of like we did Casey's desk.
So I think that's a solid start on hers. Try to get these drawings done. Our second meeting, they want this challenge coin at the center of their
This one, we're gonna start with the top.
They wanna keep it similar size to what they have. 14-foot table. It's gonna have to come in two parts to get it in the elevator, right?
So these will be where we're gonna have an acrylic ring to display. The base is gonna be three pillars. That's somewhere to run electrical up into, because they do want, like, we have to put an electrical hub here and then power.
Putting ones and zeros.
Zero, so like something matrix. That looks like the matrix is like raining, you know how like looks like codes are raining down. And then Jordan had the idea of like a computer tower.
Yeah, that's what I was gonna say, that something like this would look cool with their logo, with this logo in it.
Computer tower. Well, here's it, we're not doing like, I'm sorry, I am the lead on this. One logo and then the rest is all accent. We're not gonna do a logo in every little itty bitty part because then it takes away from the main thing.
So I like where we've gotten with the design for the conference table. I think this is probably gonna be one of our coolest projects we've ever done. The tower thing we do need to figure out, so we'll get back to that. And then the hair salon is also, I think, gonna be pretty badass too. I'm super pumped. We do have one more meeting this week at a client's home. They have a farm, but because we got hair salons on the mind. Who wants a haircut?
Ooh, can you clean me up a little bit? A little on the side.
You do need a trim.
Let's do it.
Super stoked to be working with Wall again this year and to be able to cut my own hair, trim my own hair, and then give the guys a little snip here. My mom's owned a hair salon my whole life, so I have a little bit of experience cutting hair. I used to trim up a lot of the guys in college in the locker room and in the dorms. So when Wall reached out, I thought it was the perfect fit, considering we don't have as much time these days to head to the hair salon or the barber, whomever you go to. And if with some confidence, you can cut your own hair or at least keep it tidy enough to get you to that next appointment. So if you're in the market or looking to tidy up your hairline, maybe save a few bucks from going to the hair salon, check out Wall. They've got some awesome products. These new clippers could literally cut through anything. They're self-sharpening. Jordan's hair is as thick as a horse, cuts right through that. And I think he looks pretty good for me doing his hair. So thank you, Wall, for sponsoring this video. If you guys want to check out more, there's a link down in the description. Now let's get back to hustling around to these clients.
So the last meeting of the week, it is 3:30 on a Friday and the work doesn't stop. We're heading to a client who I think I mentioned before has wood that fell on his property. He had it milled, it's chilling. I went up and saw it a year ago and I brought the guys because he's got a cool piece of property. We should get a nice little sunset film sesh while we load up the wood and bring it back. I think he's got some epic ideas for his wood. So this should be a fun one. I usually don't like using other people's wood because it's usually junk and we run into a lot of issues, but I think this is gonna be a good one. Now that we've got all the wood back in the shop, the next thing we need to do for this client is give them an idea of what the hell we're gonna build. We've got three coffee tables that they want us to try to use these slabs or cookies for, end tables somehow to match, a desk and a river table. So we're gonna lay the river table out, send them some options, and we'll kind of show you guys how we do that. Hopefully they like it because they cut the wood and we don't really have a choice besides using it. So we're gonna move some stuff around and get some mock-ups. So we've mocked up the A and B slabs. We're just giving them any sort of number here. These end boards are about 40 inches wide and their existing table's 40 inches wide. They said there's a little bit of leeway for something wider, but you typically don't want to push it because you can't reach the middle of the table if it gets too big. So now that we've got that done, we've got ideas for the hair salon. We've got them for the second client that we went to and now the third. We're gonna send these over to the client with some mock-ups, get their feedback, and then you're gonna see us build it, hopefully. But that's gonna be a wrap on this video. Give us any questions that you've got down below because this was a little bit of a different one for us. We wanna know how you guys liked it, if you got any suggestions for the future, and if you wanna see more ridiculousness, check this playlist out right here.